Hello, Copperheads! My name is Kupri, and so far in this channel we have covered 1. An overview of Wilson's disease, 2. The basics of human genetics and the inheritance of Wilson's disease, 3. The basics of gene expression, gene ATP7B and protein ATP7B, 4. The basics of human metabolism, and 5. An overview of the symptoms of Wilson's disease. You already know so much. I am so proud of you and so excited that you want to keep learning together with me. The next few videos are going to be about the diagnostic process, and I'm going to take the opportunity to teach you more about different body parts. For example, when we learn about the eye examination that can help diagnose Wilson's disease, I will teach you more about the human eye, because in order for you to understand what KF rings and sunflower cataracts are, you need to know what normal eyes look like. But that's gonna be a bit later on. The first thing we're gonna cover next week are the blood and urine tests that should always be performed towards the beginning of the diagnostic process. And today I wanna prepare you for that by teaching you math. And if you're like, but Kupri, I hate math. Please don't go, I just need to tell you about 3 little tiny things: units, concentrations, and percentages. And all you need in order to do this kind of math is pen, paper, and knowing how to add, subtract, multiply, and divide decimal numbers using a calculator. If you need a little review on decimal arithmetic, here is a good video made by the nice folks at Math Antics. So let's get started with number 1, units. Copperheads, I have a confession to make. I hope this doesn't cause you to unfollow me and shun me forever. It's so hard to say it. I don't like coffee. Seriously, I hate it. So whenever I host any kind of gathering at my house and people want to drink coffee, I'm just like, I only have instant coffee and I have no idea how to make it, so could you please do it for me? Seriously, I'm so clueless that if you go like, oh, it's easy, just add 4 of instant coffee to a pot of boiling water, I'm gonna say, for what? 4 teaspoons, 4 tablespoons, 4 cups, 4 buckets, what? And that, my friend, is why units are important. Maybe for you personally, it's obvious that it should be 4 tablespoons, but you don't know how they make coffee in other people's homes or in other people's countries. So if we're gonna have a meaningful discussion about how to make coffee, we need to say the units. For example, 4 tablespoons of instant coffee. Let's segue into number 2, concentrations. The concentration in this case tells us how many units of instant coffee should be in 1 unit of water. It's not enough for you to tell me how much instant coffee I need to add. You also need to tell me how much water I need to add the instant coffee to. If I add 4 tablespoons to 1 cup of water, that's like so strong it's not really drinkable, I guess we've already established that I don't know anything about coffee. And if I add 4 tablespoons to 1 huge barrel of water, you probably can't taste the coffee at all. So that, my friend, is why concentration units are important. Perhaps for you it's obvious that it should be 4 tablespoons in a small pot of water, but you don't know how big my pots are, so you should tell me, Kupri, you need to add 4 tablespoons of coffee to 1 liter of water. We can write it like this: 4 tablespoons of instant coffee per 1 liter of water. I'm saying per, but I could also say divided by, because that's what this horizontal fraction line means. I can also write it like this: 4 tablespoons instant coffee per liter water. And we know that when we say liter, we mean 1 liter. I can even write it this way: 4 tablespoons per liter, but only if it's already been established that we're talking about instant coffee and water. So now I'm ready to make some coffee, except I have 2 problems. First problem is, I don't have a standard US tablespoon at home, but I do have a standard US teaspoon. I can use Google to find out that there are 3 teaspoons in a tablespoon. The second problem is that I don't have anything to measure 1 liter, but I do have something to measure 1 gallon. And I can use Google to find out that 1 gallon is roughly 3.785 liters. A gallon is a ton of coffee, but don't worry because I have a lot of visitors in my house right now. So, if I know that I need to add 4 tablespoons per liter, how do I find out how many teaspoons I need for 1 gallon? Let's do some unit conversion to find out. We draw this fraction line. At the top we write 4 tablespoons and at the bottom we write 1 liter. This means 4 tablespoons per liter. Now we want to convert tablespoons to teaspoons. So next to the first fraction, we write a multiplication sign and a second fraction line. On the first fraction, tablespoons were at the top. So on the second fraction, we write tablespoons at the bottom. And on the empty spot at the top of the second fraction, we write teaspoons. We know that there are 3 teaspoons in a tablespoon, so we fill the fraction in. Now this second fraction says 3 teaspoons per tablespoon. The tablespoons at the top of the first fraction and at the bottom of the second fraction cancel each other out, so we can cross them out like this. Now we want to convert liters to gallons, so next to the second fraction we write another multiplication sign and a third fraction line. On the first fraction, liters were at the bottom, so on the third fraction we write liters at the top. And on the empty spot at the bottom of the third fraction, we write gallons. We know that there are 3.785 liters in a gallon, so we fill the fraction in. Now this third fraction says 3.785 liters per gallon. The liters at the bottom of the first fraction and at the top of the third fraction cancel each other out, so we can cross them out like that. Let's write an equal sign and condense this a little bit so it's easier to see what we have done so far. We write a longer fraction sign. At the top, we write what's left at the top of the previous 3 fractions. Keep in mind that the multiplication signs from earlier apply to both the tops and bottoms of all fractions. So at the top of the long fraction line, we write 4 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 3.785 teaspoons. And at the bottom, we write 1 multiplied by 1 multiplied by 1 gallons. Let's write another equal sign and another fraction line, and we can do the math with a calculator. First, we do the top math, so that's 4 times 3 times 3.785 equal 45.42 teaspoons at the top. And then we do the bottom math, so that's 1 times 1 times 1 equal 1 gallon at the bottom. In other words, 45.42 teaspoons of instant coffee per gallon of water. Woohoo, we did it! Now let's move on to the third part, percentages. Let's say I am a nerd who wants to know what percentage of my instant coffee is caffeine.
Me, a nerd, what?
I look at the package and it says there are 3000 milligrams of caffeine in 100 grams of instant coffee. So let's make a fraction. At the top we write 3000 milligrams of caffeine, and at the bottom we write 100 grams of instant coffee. We have to make sure the weight units at the top and at the bottom are the same, so now I want to convert milligrams of caffeine to grams of caffeine by multiplying these by a second fraction. I know that 1 gram equals 1000 milligrams. On the first fraction, milligrams of caffeine were at the top, so on the second fraction we write them at the bottom. And then we put the grams of caffeine at the top. So now this second fraction says 1 gram of caffeine per 1000 milligrams of caffeine. The milligrams of caffeine at the top of the first fraction and at the bottom of the second fraction cancel each other out, so we can cross them out like this. Let's clean this up by writing an equal sign and another fraction line. At the top we are left with 3000 grams of caffeine, and at the bottom we are left with 100 times 1000 grams of instant coffee. We do the top and bottom math separately, so we have 3000 grams of caffeine at the top and 100,000 grams of coffee at the bottom. We divide those numbers with a calculator and the result is 0.03 grams of caffeine per gram of instant coffee. To make this number into a percentage, we multiply it by 100. So 0.03 times 100 equals 3% of caffeine in instant coffee by weight. Now imagine another scenario in which we have the information the other way around. In this other scenario, we don't know how many grams of caffeine there are in a gram of instant coffee, but we do know the percentage. And we want to find out how much caffeine there is in the huge 1 gallon pot of coffee we made earlier. So we know from earlier that we use 45.42 teaspoons of instant coffee for the whole 1 gallon pot. The USDA website tells me that 1 teaspoon of instant coffee weighs 1 gram, which means we used 45.42 grams of instant coffee. And we know that instant coffee has 3% of caffeine by weight. So let's write it like this, 3 grams of caffeine in 100 grams of instant coffee, and X grams of caffeine in 45.42 grams of instant coffee. We are interested in this X, which is unknown. So we write X equals and a fraction line. Now here's the trick to remembering what goes where. We draw a cross up here, where we wrote our information. We take the number across from the x and we write it at the bottom. So that's 100 at the bottom of the fraction. And we take the other two numbers and we multiply them on top. So that's 3 times 45.42 at the top of the fraction. We write another equal sign on a fraction line and we do the top and bottom math separately. So that's 136.26 at the top and 100 at the bottom. We divide them using a calculator and the result is 1.3626 grams of caffeine in 1 gallon of the coffee we made earlier. Alright, Copperheads, that's all the math for today. And if you're wondering, what the heck does coffee have to do with Wilson's disease? The answer is, well, not much. I was just using this as an example to teach you some math skills we're gonna need next week when we look at some of the blood and urine tests involved in diagnosing Wilson's disease. Thank you so much for watching, and don't forget, you can subscribe on YouTube, follow on Instagram, like on Facebook, or send me an email. My name is Kupri. See you there, Copperheads!